Marriage Counseling by JustMyMom.com. Today, the Western world features a divorce rate of nearly 50%. Some countries have higher rates. So why are we seeing a rise in divorce, and the way can guidance help save marriages, you and others? I think it's fair to mention that the better you create things, the more often it'll happen. If it becomes more frequent, it loses its taboo and thus becomes far more acceptable within the eyes of society. My wife comes from a divorced family. When he was a toddler at college, he was within the minority, which was a stigma. Today, my children are within the minority of these whose parents are still together. Of course, one among the most effects of divorce is on the family. The impact on children is usually underestimated, and that we must recognize that albeit one in two marriages may end, regardless of how common, it doesn't diminish the impact on the family. Marriage counseling may be a sort of therapy and conflict resolution. This is often usually done by a trained psychotherapist, although not always. To figure properly, both parties got to be present, although separate sessions will likely help. If you're considering seeing a wedding counselor, then here are some points to think about and inquiries to ask to assist save the wedding. Is that the first assessment session free? What percentage times every week is needed? Does one get to pay after each session? Is that the marriage counselor eligible? Maybe a marriage counselor recommended by someone you trust. How long will each session last? Are you ready to contact the wedding counselor outside of session time? Will the session fit into your work schedule? I am all for guidance to save lots of marriages, however, fairly often people are paid large sums for obvious blinding shows. Many problems are screaming for attention and typically have my friends and family. Of course, having independent ears are often very useful, but you'll accomplish tons on your own. With the proper techniques, you'll do guidance on your own. Marriage counseling. Marriage is sweet for your health, wealth, and happiness. Marriage keeps you healthy, United States government researchers reported in December. Consistent with a replacement study by the Centers for Disease Control, married people are less likely to smoke, drink heavily, or be physically inactive. They're less likely than single, divorced, or widowed adults to be in fair or poor health, and more likely to suffer headaches or psychological problems. It might be NAG factor, consistent with Barbara Bartline, author of Why Did I Marry You Anyway? 12.5 Strategies for a Cheerful Marriage. Couples tend to bother one another about health problems like smoking, drinking, risky behavior, and receiving regular medical aid. Ironically, people have climbed the ladder of success by working long hours and taking over additional projects, often sacrificing family time. Now, new research shows that they're going to be healthier, richer, and happier if they concentrate more on their marriage. There appear to be serious consequences for couples calling it quits too easy that haven't been addressed in previous studies. We've created disposable weddings during a throwaway culture with little regard for private expenses for people and families. If you're trying to find an extended and healthy life, marriage could also be a part of the solution. Married people tend to measure longer and healthier lives than their single, divorced, or widowed partners. And while my husband will claim that it just seems like it lasts longer, statistics show this is often true. Non-married have a way higher death rate, 50% higher among women and 250% higher among men. For men, staying married increases the prospect of survival to age 65 from about 2 in 3 to just about 9 in 10. The unmarried are much more likely to die from all causes, including coronary heart condition, stroke, pneumonia, cancer, cirrhosis, car accidents, homicide, and suicide. Getting married improves psychological state for both men and ladies. There's someone to speak to. Couples discuss their worries, dreams, and disappointments with their partners, which helps relieve stress and anxiety. Researchers also found that there was a positive effect of the nag factor. This is, routines that your partner does to encourage a positive lifestyle and reduce destructive habits like smoking or drinking excessively. A healthy marriage also can be a start line for growing net worth. Not only is divorce very costly within the short term, the future effects of not being married dramatically affect how financially secure you become. Consider, the longer people stay married, the greater their accumulated wealth. At retirement, the standard marriage has raised approximately $410,000 compared to about $167,000 for never marrying, about $145,000 for divorcing, and slightly below $96,000 for being separated. Spouses have better health and life assurance coverage. Getting married has increased access to pensions and social security. Married provides insurance. Just in case of death, spouses nearly always leave behind their virtual goods, social security and retirement benefits for his or her wives or husbands. By getting married, partners create an equivalent annuity value by increasing an individual's wealth by 12-14% at age 30 and 30% at age 75 compared to remaining single. Married people behave more responsibly about money because they need more responsibilities. By accumulating money, labor, and time, married people create more opportunities to create wealth. There's also value for in-law. They tend to assist the family when needed. In-law also provides potential access to the inheritance. About 29% of married couples received financial assistance from in-laws, and a few quarters of families with children received financial transfers within the last 5 years. Apart from jokes and comedy routines, married people also tend to be happier than their single counterparts. Married men and ladies report less depression, less anxiety, and lower levels of psychological distress than those that are single, divorced, or widowed. Asterisk widowed and divorced people are about 3 times more likely to kill. Asterisk legal status is one among the foremost important predictors of happiness. 40% of these who were married said they were very proud of their life generally, compared to only under 1/4 of these who were single or cohabitation. The commitment to form marriage a priority will have an incredible impact on your life. A recipe for fulfillment for health, wealth, and happiness: work as hard on your marriage as you've got in your career. Marriage counseling: use the waiter rule to gauge a date or partner. Working my way through college, I waited for a table and attended the bar. Although I even have several degrees with stress on human behavior and psychology, I swear I learned tons more about people from hash slinging and pouring drinks. I remember accidentally spilling a couple of drops of frozen dessert on a woman's skirt and being completely humiliated when she yelled at me during a restaurant. I also remember a kind man who wasn't angry despite repeated problems together with his orders. Rudeness to maintenance staff revealing information a few persons' characters was reported during a recent article on USA Today. Office Depot CEO Steve Odland, who also waited for tables as an adolescent, stated, "You can tell tons of few people by the way he treats waiters." It seems that he wasn't the sole CEO who invented the waiter rule. The waiter rule has been identified by many executives, including Raytheon CEO Bill Swanson. There's one rule Swanson says never fails: someone good to you but rude to a waiter, or anyone else, isn't a pleasant person. Swanson first identified this phenomenon when he was eating with a person who became angry at a waiter because the restaurant didn't stock certain wines. Watch out for people that have a situational value system, which may activate and deactivate charms counting on the status of the person they interact with, Swanson wrote. Beware of these who are rude to people that are considered to be during a subordinate role. The waiter rule has also been noticed on the dating scene. November survey 2500 by It's Just Lunch, a dating service for professionals, found being rude to waiters was a no. One because the worst in dining etiquette. Some writers report that the ladies will pull them aside to ascertain what proportion of their tip date is to realize insight into the utilization of cash and other tendencies. The waiter rules also can apply to how people treat people in other service roles like waiters, hotel maids, clerks, and secretaries, consistent with USA Today. It can convey more of an individual's character than all the charm you experience during a relationship. Using servants' rules are often an accurate predictor of character because they're neither easy to find out nor easy to find out. This is often more likely an individual's true color and speaks of how they were raised and their value system. How a possible partner treats a waiter could also be how they're going to treat you. Some behaviors that indicate a problem, asterisk playing electric cards. Comments like, "I can purchase this place," or, "Do you recognize who I am?" reveals more a few restaurants' characters than its wealth or strength. It's unlikely that he will have compassion for you if he's consumed with power and control. Asterisk features a short fuse. This person may have an ego that's out of control. It is a way of claiming he's better than the wait staff, he's special. These people are less likely to be collaborative in relationships. Asterisk demands about every detail. You'll see micromanagers consistently send the message that your efforts aren't okay. He could also be critical and condescending instead of supportive and inspiring. Asterisk speak condescendingly. The message here is clear. He thought he was better than those within the subordinate position. He may have to feel important by putting others down. Asterisk make public scenes. If he humiliates you at the restaurant, he will embarrass you reception. At the best he had ill breeding, at worst, his judgment was wrong. Either way, he won't make an honest match. Asterisk easy to activate and deactivate charms. These people have situational values, which may also demonstrate situational ethics. People of decisive character adhere to their value system no matter the circumstances. Avoid people just like the plague. Asterisk constantly shop around the space. Rather than that specialize in table conversation, he was distracted and uninvolved. He's probably looking to ascertain who else is there or if he's being noticed. Regardless, it'll have an equivalent behavior as you in the other setting. Asterisk poor tipper. She may justify leaving a nasty tip with various complaints about service or waiters. Anyone who has worked within the industry knows that it's incredible diligence for a coffee-based salary. If service is adequate, a 15% tip is customary. One-fifth or more of gratitude is that the standard for exceptional service. Try using the servant rule whether you evaluate partners during a relationship. You'll save yourself tons of trouble within the future by eating out. Marriage counseling: when to save lots of your relationship. Happiness and fulfillment are two big components of a successful marriage. An absence which, alongside other things, can ultimately cause a marital disaster. The most basic principles that guidance teaches are to save lots of existing relationships from total collapse and to steer both partners back on the trail of marital happiness. Albeit guidance can work for a few people, the reality remains the reality. Some marriages may never be saved. For both conditions, there are reasons and appropriate factors. Many of those are going to be discussed in the following paragraphs. But rock bottom line for both factors is that the willingness of both parties to revive the damaged relationship is the most motivating factor. There are several reasons why couples seek guidance. This is often natural because there are endless possibilities for why people create conflict in their marriages. While it's widely accepted that each one marriage is bombarded with hardships a while in their lives, it's sad to notice that a lot of don't seem to place them aside. And most fall under the divorce trap. The most natural conditions during which guidance is usually sought are when the spouse feels frustrated, extreme grief, and is seriously injured. These are often not new between couples and are growing around for years. Unfortunately, the sole time that folks enter guidance is when the connection is already on the sting of ending. This is often reason enough why young couples or those that haven't begun to feel a fraction in their relationship have a greater chance of improving their marriage. It is not wrong to aspire to happiness. But rarely like that. To rule out further problems, it's knowing to accept this reality and work towards achieving happiness during a more sensible and realistic approach. Marriage is tough work. This needs partners to plan to the results of their relationship. They often got to suspend their egos and to drop claims for who is true to urge around issues which will send them screaming during dinner. Agreeing to drop the "who's right" thing is a crucial part of both marriage and guidance. Without this, everything could be vain. It may are observed that throughout this text, saving the marriage is merely a central discussion. But rebuke couples who enforce divorce? The guidance also can answer that. However, it's going to be a way longer process, especially when children are at stake. If the marriage can't be saved, then the simplest solution for this is often for the couple to show into friends or be willing to be parents together towards the expansion of their children. During this way, pain is often reduced while contributing to a way constructive process. During the dissolution stage, extreme pain and a mix of other emotions are often felt. This state of affairs could also be further exacerbated by overt emotional and physical separation. For many of the cases, this country may come to a level of mourning and distress. The guidance could also be most helpful during this condition because it can help bring out undisclosed emotions between partners. Once the signs of marriage breakdown have made themselves transparent to the couple, it's best to hunt guidance within the earliest possible time. Otherwise, you could also be too late to save lots of the connection. Marriage counseling for prevention. The unfortunate byproduct of our isolated culture is that therapy, including counseling, is seen as a symbol of weakness or that the connection has turned sour. This doesn't need to be the case. Actually, many strong marital relationships can enjoy the services knowledgeable counselor offers. There are several stages in marriage, and counseling is often vital in each of them. The primary stage is that the time before the couple gets married, after the choice to require big steps has been made. Good counseling nowadays can help couples anticipate areas of conflict that will arise when events occur. A spouse who has not previously lived together might not be fully prepared for what it means to possess somebody else to sleep in your life 24 hours each day, 7 days every week. These couples must be prepared for the challenges facing them. Shaping the division of the household and other workloads for issues that will arise when it involves finances, sex, and leisure. Couples who have lived together can also find some pre-marriage counseling helpful because the actual marriage process seems to vary relationship expectations in many various ways. Above all, counseling before marriage can help couples identify potential problems within the relationship which will be exacerbated after the commitment has been made. Marriage counseling during marriage also can help strengthen relationships as identify potential areas of conflict before they boil right down to bigger fights. A counselor is trained to listen to what people ask to say, while a few during a marriage is certain to filter a number of the opposite people's messages, regardless of how they believe they're putting it forward. Hence, an attentive counselor is often expected to possess the power to steer problems on the path. Marriages also are subject to considerable upheaval with the arrival of a replacement baby. And family dynamics are often expected to vary with the arrival of every subsequent child. A marriage counselor will again have the background to enable him or her to spot potential problem spots and education to supply solutions to problems so partners don't find their relationship ambushed in times of turmoil. Regardless of how you are feeling about the strength of your relationship, good guidance may be a great option just to form sure that the lines of communication remain open. Even people that are desperately crazy might not realize that their partner doesn't share an equivalent impression of the individual's situation. A counselor will help identify and clarify these areas and offer solutions to stay them from arising within the future. Remember that counseling isn't a symbol of weakness. It doesn't even mean that there are always problems in your relationship. On the opposite hand, it's going to be just another tool to stay your relationship to the simplest of it. Marriage counseling. Are you a workaholic? Justin, a 35-year-old executive at a high-pressure investment company, works 60 to 70 hours per week. Even while on vacation, he often sneaks far away from other relations to travel online, check messages, and answer phone calls. Until now, he had seen nothing abnormal about his behavior. Actually, everyone at his job works like that. In US, we value work. Americans work longer hours than workers in other industrialized countries. In fact, in Western Europe, Americans are seen as a nation of workaholics. According to a 1998 study by the Families and Work Institute in NY, the typical American now works 44 hours per week, which represents a rise of 3.5 hours since 1977. This is much more than workers in France, 39 hours per week, and Germany, 40. Consistent with a replacement report from the United Nations ILO International Labour Organization, workers within US put in additional hours than anyone else within the industrialized world. ILO statistics show that in 2000, the typical American worked almost one person more workweeks than within the previous year, worked a mean of 1,978 hours, up from 1,942 hours in 1990. Americans now work longer hours than Canadian, Japanese, or Australian workers. What can we work for? This is often not a vacation. Typical American workers have a mean of the fortnight of vacation compared to 4-6 weeks for his or her European counterparts. For happiness? Consistent with a daily survey by the National Opinion Research Facility of the University of Chicago, no more Americans report they're very happy now than they were in 1957, despite nearly double their personal consumption expenditure. Indeed, people around the world have consumed the maximum amount of goods and services since 1950 as all previous generations put together, but report that they're not happier. It costs such a lot to figure so hard. People tend to spend less and less time with their families. A recent survey found that almost a third of individuals who worked quite 48 hours every week said that fatigue was affecting married life. Nearly a third acknowledged that work-related fatigue caused their sex life to suffer, and 14% reported a loss or reduced drive. They also complained that the long hours and excessive work led to arguments and tension reception. 2 in 5 people that work quite 48 hours every week blamed long hours for disputes and said they felt guilty for not pulling their weight off with household chores. So how does one know if your job has become a workaholic habit? Here are some warning signs. colleagues describe you as hardworking, necessary to win, and too committed. Keep your technology tethers, like cell phones, pagers and laptops with you in the least times, even on vacation. Good friends don't call again, otherwise you quickly get off the phone once they call. Sleeping looks like a waste of your time. Circle work problems in your mind, even during the leave. Work causes you to happier than the other aspect of your life. If you experience a number of these warning signs daily, it's going to be time to re-evaluate how you handle the add your life. A healthy marriage takes time and commitment. Do not be so busy making a living that you simply forget to form a living. Marriage counseling, prevent therapist-assisted marriage suicide. People want to urge married and stay married. In fact, consistent with a study by the Family Service of America, quite 70% of Yank adults believe that marriage may be a lifelong commitment. Interestingly, even 81% of divorced and separated Americans still believe marriage should be for all times. However, quite half all marriages end in divorce. Too often, even couples seeking professional help don't receive the tools they have. As divorce became more socially acceptable within the 1970s and 1980s, many therapists assisted in marital suicide by seeing divorce as a lifestyle choice or as a pathway to non-public growth. Despite these good means, too often they advise clients to urge divorced claims without full knowledge of the large consequences of divorce. At best, they took a marriage-neutral attitude to whatever causes you to happy, with no knowledge of current research on happiness. The study of divorce and happiness shows that a lot of divorced people are less happy 5 years after a divorce. Your spouse working through their problems and avoiding divorce tends to possess higher levels of happiness after 5 years. So why don't couples work harder to form their marriage work? Because they do not have the tools. Barbara Bartline, clinical psychotherapist and author of Why Did I Marry You Anyway? 12.5 Strategies for a Cheerful Marriage, has developed a program to enhance your relationship. You study, how do wedding doom therapists why do marriages fail? Myth number one that sabotages the success of a wedding tools that assist clients in building trust and commitment strategies for building long-term relationships. Marriage counseling, tips to measure longer. We've all heard the stories, executives retire within the spring and die before the primary winter snows. While some might conclude that former executives simply couldn't suit retirement, it's more likely that they burned themselves to figure. That is, years of adjusting their well-being ended up getting cursed with them. It's easy to urge stuck on a treadmill on a demanding schedule and use too many priorities of using caffeinated energy to urge things done. It's often self-care which will be placed on the primary shelf because there's no time to exercise and eat right. However, there's increasing research that even small lifestyle changes are often serious. Think about an extended healthy life. Some suggestions: keep the fuse long. Scientists used to believe that type A, people that are driven by ambition, are most in danger for heart attacks. But recent research shows that it doesn't strive for goals that have people dropping like flies, it becomes hostile, angry, and cynical. A hostile disposition is additionally dangerous once the disorder has entered. Dr. Murray Mittleman, a cardiovascular epidemiologist at Beth Israel Deaconess Center in Boston, interviewed 1623 men and ladies who had an attack. He found that those that were angry were twice as likely to possess an attack within the 2 hours before the incident. Relax. There's increasing evidence linking depression to a heart condition. Johns Hopkins researchers interviewed 1,551 people within the early 1980s who were freed from a heart condition. They reported a history of major depression were fourfold as likely to possess an attack as those that weren't depressed. Get off the sofa. Not just for weight control, better circulation, reduced risk of diabetes, but exercise works as an antidepressant. During a recent study at Duke University, 60% of individuals with a depressive disorder who walked fast half hour a minimum of 3 times per week were not depressed after 16 weeks. Increasingly, psychiatrists are finding that exercise can often work also as antidepressants for people who are slightly depressed. Smooth the middle. It has been quite 50 years since French scientist Jean Vague noted that folks with tons of upper body fat, those who appear as if apples, not pears, often develop a heart condition, diabetes, and other ailments. Since the introduction of CT and MRI scans, doctors have found that visceral fat, which is found within the stomach, is strongly related to this disease. The great news is that this sort of fat also burns the fastest. This is often why even little loss of weight can reverse the lethal factors of the heart condition. Limit bad habits. Heavy drinking, smoking, overeating, and overcaffeinating are major factors within the development of heart conditions and other problems. Drinking and smoking tend to extend belly fat, which puts people in danger for a heart condition. Excess caffeine raises a vital sign to dangerous levels for people under job stress. Stir up your metabolism. New research shows that a healthy metabolic profile counts much more than cardiovascular fitness or weight alone. During a Japanese study, albeit they didn't reduce or improve their cardiovascular fitness, their metabolic health improved dramatically, measured by how well the body used insulin. Glenn A. Glaser states of the University of Virginia, "Metabolic fitness is one among the simplest protections against heart condition, stroke, and diabetes. Approach to sleep like Goldilocks, right?" During a recent study of 72,000 nurses published within the January Archives of General Medicine, researchers found that getting insufficient sleep, or an excessive amount of, can increase the danger of developing a heart condition. Women who got a mean of 5 hours or less of sleep an evening were 39% more likely to develop heart condition than those that got 8 hours. And 9 hours or more of shut-eye was related to a 37% higher risk of the heart condition. Your best investment for the longer term is in your health today. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe my YouTube channel Just My Mom. www.justmymom.com